democratize the use of force. So the mob can determine what happens in India, it's not the state. For this reason, I think it will actually continue, that we will go through a period where the mob is empowered and will stop or try to stop what it feels should not happen. Violence is not punished by the state. Indeed, the victims of violence are punished most of the time. For this reason, I think the genie has left the bottle, and to expect even with the change of government in 2024 that things of this sort will immediately return to normal will not actually happen. I'll turn to the second vector now on what has changed after 2014. So this is on the side of the economy, and what Mr. Modi has done through we are now in year 8, the facts are these. 5 crore fewer people have jobs today than had in 2013, and this is the government data. This is despite the fact that 12 crore more people came off working age. The labor force participation rate in the US is 60%. This is that a proportion of the population that is off working age, 15 and more. It is 60% in the US, it's about 70% in Thailand, it's about 75% in China and in Vietnam, it is 40% here. The labor force participation rate of this country is lower than that of Pakistan. There are more women in Pakistan who work today who are over the age of 15 than women here. Jobs in manufacturing halved from 5.1 crore to 2.7 crore after 2016. The number of people who work in MGNREGA, which Mr. Modi called a monument to failure, has gone up by 4 times. So the budget for MGNREGA in 2013-14 was 30,000 crore, then it doubled to 60,000 crore. Last year it was 1,11,000 crore. This year the money has run out in the first 7 months. Indians were spending less and eating less in 2018 than they were in 2012. This is government data. This survey was not released, but it was leaked. The chief economic advisor who is leaving this week, Subramaniam, said that it should be released, but Mr. Modi has chosen not to put it out. GDP growth began a sequential decline, meaning it started falling from January 2018, according to government data, and for 13 quarters, for 3 years and 3 months, it's been on the way down. The RBI, the Reserve Bank of India, has a consumer confidence survey which asks people, were you better off last year or are you better off today? And for 5 years, except for 1 month, which is April 2019, the majority of people have said that they were worse off today than they were 1 year ago. Manufacturing's share of GDP has fallen after the Make in India program from 16% to 13% in the same period. Bangladesh has been able to raise it, and Bangladesh, which was 50% behind India in per capita GDP terms in 2014, has today gone in front of us. The middle class has stopped growing in India. So the number of cars sold per year has not changed in 10 years. So it's about 27 lakh units. The number of houses sold in the 8 major metros has not changed in the last 10 years. It's about 3 lakh units. Last year it was less. Even the lower middle class has actually stopped growing. The number of two-wheelers sold has not grown in the last 5 years. So clearly there's a problem. But we are not able to express this problem in democratic political terms, because this is not the substance of either our media debates or the debates that we have in parliament. The Azimuddin University found that last year 23 crore people fell into poverty, and 28,000 dollar millionaires, people who have more than 7.5 crore rupees, have left India since 2014. Last year, we had 23 more crore and we had 55 people who became billionaires. So, people who own more than 7.5 thousand crore rupees. 800 million people, 60% of the population of this country depends on 5 kilos of rice and wheat and 1 kilo of dal each month. If this scheme has been continued till the end of next March. The government survey that was released this year shows that the number of people, the number of children who are stunted or wasted because of malnutrition has gone up in some states. In some states, including Gujarat, it is worse than it was in 2005. Out of 53 global indices, India has fallen on 49 since 2014. And this is also something that I've tracked in my new book. Many of these indices are run by conservative organizations like the World Bank, the World Economic Forum, and they can't be dismissed as just being something that the liberals and the leftists are seeing. To sum up, on two fronts, I think we have shifted course since 2014. On the first, we have become a majoritarian in many ways by law. So the secular part of the constitution, the preamble which the BJP is trying to get rid of through a bill that it has passed in the Rajya Sabha, that it has actually introduced in the Rajya Sabha, is only that word. I think that the real meaning of the constitution comes from these post 2015 laws on beef, on marriage, that on CAA and things like that, that are specifically aimed at the community. And second, that the economic problems that we are in the midst of are very deep. They will continue, especially because just like the persecution of Muslims, the problems of the economy are not the part of a conversation in this democracy, in our parliament. And for this reason, I think that it will continue. Thank you very much.